Hello, welcome to East Chicago Central. I'd like to welcome everyone and thank everyone for coming out to our first East Chicago Central Black History virtual program. Also, I'd like to thank our great Miss Katrina Alexander for putting this program together, working with all the community partners and making sure this is a success. And also thank you to all the kids that's involved. Thank you and happy Black History Month.
Lift Every Voice and Sing is a hymn written as a poem by James Weldon Johnson in 1900 and set to music by his brother, J. Roseman Johnson, for the anniversary of Abraham Lincoln's birthday in 1905. In 1919, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, or NAACP, dubbed it the Negro National Anthem for its power in voicing a cry for liberation and affirmation for African American people. The song is a prayer of thanksgiving for faithfulness and freedom, which imagery evoking the biblical exodus from slavery to the freedom of the promised land. It is featured in 39 different Christian hymnals and is sung in churches across North America. Lift every voice and sing.
Down on my knees. Oh, carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gon' come. Oh, yes it will.
My name is Makaya Knowles, and I will be reading a poem by Amanda Gorman, The Hill We Climb. When the day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. And the norms and notions of what just isn't always just ice. And yet, the dawn is ours. Before we know it, somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny black girl descended from the slaves and was raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president, only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge a union with purpose, to compose a country committed of all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. And so we fit our gazes not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide we know. We put our future first. We must put our differences aside so we can reach our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true. That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hoped. That even as we tried, we tried. That will forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never know defeat, but because we will never show division. Scripture tell us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If we to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but in all bridges we've made. There is no promise glad the hill we climb. We dare. It's because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it. We've seen a forest that would shatter our nation rather than share it. We would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded, but while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith, we trust. For while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of redemption. We feared at this inception. We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour. But within, we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So while we asked how we could possibly prevail over a catastrophe, now we assert, how could a catastrophe possibly prevail over us? We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be. A country that is bruised but whole, malevolent but bold, fierce and free. We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and interior will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens. But one thing is certain, if we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than one we were left with. Every breath from my bronze pounded chest, we will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one. We will rise from the gold-limbed hills of the West. We will rise from the widespread Northeast, where our forefathers first realized revolution. We will rise from lake rim cities of the Midwestern states. We will rise from the sun-baked South. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover in every known nook of our nation and every corner called our country. Our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge, battered and beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade, unflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light. If only we brave enough to see it, only we brave enough to be it.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure. The heavens, no man, no weapon formed against. Yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, the spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up. One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure. Every man, woman, and child. Even Jesus got his crown in front of a crowd. They march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. Never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. The biggest weapon, is to stay peaceful. We sing, our music is the cuts that we bleed through. Somewhere in the dream we had an epiphany. Now we right the wrongs in history. No one can win a war individually. It takes the wisdom of the elders and young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There is so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, oh yeah. Again, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer.